Kavanaugh will film
you. Okay. All right, we're going to see if we can do this live here. Okay, so we're just going to get right into this because I have so many things I want to talk about with my business and marketing tips. Now, these are my business and marketing tips. I'm sure there's other awesome marketing people in here that go ahead and jump in if you have any things to say. We're a small group. This is awesome. And the people that aren't here yet are missing out. So here we go. Okay, so I am all about, and here I am. I've got to watch where I'm going because I run around a lot. I'm all about being unique and different with your business. So the origami things are set her apart with her credit card processing, which, like you said, is huge, like realtors. There's as many credit card processors as there are realtors. What makes you stand out, right? So there's going to be a few things in here that will help you with that. So I love this. I always have to show this because it's one of my favorite little graphics that people think success is just like, yeah, you just go for it. And I'm going to start something new and it's going to be easy. And I'm going to reach my goals immediately. Well, what it really looks like is obviously the other one. All over the place. I'm somewhere in the middle always. So as we all, right? So hopefully today, I'm going to give you some little keys for success and help you get that key a little bit easier, make the line a little bit straighter. So I don't know if I'm in the camera, so I think
I'm
going
to... Yes, you are.
Am I? Okay. All right. So hi, Facebook Livers. We are being live right now. I'm going to talk about Facebook Live in a minute because that has totally changed my life and what people, how they perceive me, and it's amazing. I have lots of stories about me doing a Facebook Live every day since January 1st, what it's done for me and my business. It's amazing, amazing thing it's got, and I've learned a lot, so I can't wait to teach you about Facebook Live. It's coming up soon. So what do we all want? Why do we all have our business? Why did we start it in the first place? Freedom, right? Didn't we all want to be free? We don't want a job, we don't want to be held down, all that stuff. But what happens usually when people get in business? What? We all just, we're working
more.
Working more. Way, way, way more hours than if we had a job and we went went 9 to 5 and then we get to party the rest of the time. But no. But there's something about having a business that we love. And you know what? It's, if you have a business, what is it? I can't remember who said it, but you know, if you have a job you love or you have a business that you love, you don't work a day in your life. So I think that's why we all do this. We have a passion for what we know and what we're doing, and we all want that freedom. So I'm going to hopefully give you a few tips that will help you get a little more free in your business and make it a little easier for you. So I'm just going to ask all of you, first of all, on your notes and stuff, if you need a pad or paper, we do have some other ones over here, little notebooks. How many of you know the E-Myth or read the E-Myth by Michael Gerber? Anybody? Oh, write that down. Go read it. Yes. Susan actually worked for Michael Gerber, and she's going to talk about that. We'll give her a little story probably about that in a little while. But I just want to tell the story from the E-Myth because it's really, really important for anybody in business. I don't care what kind of business you're in. The reason there's a piece of pie up there is not because no, we're all going to be hungry. But luckily, hopefully you all ate breakfast. The basic story in the E-Myth is this. It tells a story of a lady, I don't remember her name, but she loved baking pies. She learned how to bake pies from, hey Jean, there's another Jean, we have two Jeans in the house. Mm-hmm. Hi Jean, come on up here. So she loved baking pies. Her aunt taught her how to bake pies. It was her passion, it was her love. All the neighbors always wanted her to bake pies for them. She was the pie lady in the neighborhood. They loved her pies. So what do you think everybody told her to do?
Make pies.
Open a pie shop. Yes, you really need to open a pie shop. She's like, really? Okay, cool. So I believe she quit her job and she went around and started figuring out that, oh, you have to have a place and you have to have insurance and you have to have permits and you got to do all these things. And she got her whole beautiful pie shop all set up beautifully all by herself. She got new tables and linens and her kitchen was amazing. And she got up the first day and like 1 in the morning and was baking all of her pies and getting ready for the day and went to open the door when she was supposed to open and where were all her customers? Well, she realized she had to learn how to do marketing. Right? She had to tell people to come to her store. So the long story short of this, of her story is this. She started doing everything in her business. She would get up at 3-4 in the morning. She would get bake her pies. She would do all of that. She would, customers would come in. She would feed the customers. She would clean up the dirty plates. She would take their money. She would get at the end of the day, she'd close the door, she'd clean up the kitchen, get everything ready for the next day, do the marketing, do her website. Okay, I did that with my tutoring business. Imagine me sitting with 3 kids and 2 phones and a computer and parents here and people calling and people wanting to pay the bill and me trying to tutor the kids. I literally did that. I pictured it in my head. I totally did that. And I was tired, and I went home and did the website, I did everything, send out emails, oh, holy cow, and the money, which is the financing. So what we need to do is all systematize our business. So the EMIT talks a lot about McDonald's, right? McDonald's is the same everywhere you go, right? I don't care if you're in England, I don't care if you're in Canada, or you're in Geneva, Nebraska, where I'm from. It is the same everywhere. So we all need to set up systems in our business. Susan is an expert at that. She actually came into my business and took all my employees and we set up a whole organizational chart and got our systems together. And that way, you can plug people into the different parts of your business and get it running without you. I just had to put this up here. Sorry we're closed, we really had no idea what we were doing. How many businesses? A lot of businesses. I think it's after 18 months, 80% of businesses are closed. Isn't that terrible? I hate that. Okay, so let's talk about marketing. Today we're going to talk about marketing, and that's what I love. And I love talking about outside the box marketing. So what's your marketing plan? Anybody have a marketing plan for their business? I'm sure this one does. Yeah, it's awesome. So there are so many different things you could do, like with marketing. I got to post on Facebook, I got to post on Instagram, I got to do a Facebook Live, I got to send out emails, I got to put up a sign, I don't know. So let's go through some really, that's what people feel like when they think about marketing, it's this maze of stuff. Especially with social media, that's the one I get the biggest, people are like, I need to learn social media. So we have an expert in the room, so I'm super excited about that. Okay, we're going to start from the beginning, real quick. Now we went over this yesterday, so you were here yesterday, but you can't hear this stuff enough, right? You just can't. I do want to tell you, I might be telling you stuff you've already heard before. You can either say, oh, I already know that, and tune out, or you can say, oh, thanks for the reminder. So let's all be kind of a thanks for the reminder kind of day today. And if you have any things to add, we're a small group right now, so let's all get together and help each other. So I'm going to go over, we were with the master of all this yesterday, but I do want to talk about, before you start your marketing plan, you got to have a strategy. You don't just go into marketing and go, oh, I'm going to post this on Facebook today, and I'm going to post this, take this picture and put it on Instagram, and I think I'll try Snapchat. I have no clue what it is, but let's just start it and figure, do something, I don't know. You got to have a strategy. So the very first thing you want to do is come up with your customer avatar. Does everybody know what an avatar is? Anybody not know avatar? Okay, good. So it's obviously your ideal client, the perfect person, the most profitable, the one that's going to pay you, not the one that can't pay you or is late paying you. You want to find that ideal customer that's your favorite customer that you would like to have a million of. Okay? So get that in your head. Now, when someone told me that I have to come up with my perfect customer, my ideal client, my avatar, I'm like, well, I want my avatar to be single moms who have no money, that really need help. They need so much help because I just want to help them so much. And they don't have any money, but that's okay because I'll just help them and give them deals. And I totally did that. I did. So that's not your most profitable avatar. It wasn't mine. So you've got to figure out who it is. So the best thing for you to do, if you have a business already, does everybody have in their head a customer that you have that's like, oh my God, I love this person. I love working with him or her. They are amazing. They always pay me. They do what I tell them to do. They're successful. And I've really seen, that is a person. I have that person in my head. Her name is Sharon. She is amazing. I love her. She calls me, we meet, I have fun working with her, and she pays me. It's pretty cool. So think about who your perfect avatar is. So you do,
sometimes, and I'm sorry if I talk too fast, because I do, I want to get through all this stuff. So if you need me to slow down, just say, can we slow down a little bit? John Limbacher was here yesterday, and he had a saying that he says, you don't pick your customer out. You don't just go and choose them, like the single mom that doesn't have any money. You actually discover your avatar, and you discover them by doing research. So you want to know what, who they are, and where they are, and I'm not sure which is the next one there now. Are they online? Are they in front of a computer, in their house online? Are they at meetup groups? Are they at the hiking meetup groups? Are they in their offices? Where are they? Where do they hang out? And which social media platform do they hang out on? So most of my clients are on Facebook. So I spend a lot of my time on Facebook. But I need to learn Instagram because I hear they're all on Instagram. So, but figure out where your avatar is and figure out where they are. So this link right here, Make Money While I Sleep, that is a webinar that I did with John Limbacher, who was here yesterday, if you missed him. It's really good, and he will give you some really good ideas on finding your customer avatar. So when you have time, go to makemoneywhileisleep.com. So after you find your avatar, and you figure out who they are, and you know exactly how old they are, where they live, where they're hanging out, you want to speak their language, okay? Is it a man or a woman? Are you going to speak the same language? Yeah. Is it a Harley Davidson rider that's, you know, with the Hells Angels? Or is it a single mom at home? Do they speak the same language? No. So you have to figure out how they talk and what language they use in your messaging. And again, if you were here yesterday, if you weren't, it is on my Facebook Live. So you guys that are on Facebook Live, or if you're in the room, you're not, add me. Go watch the Facebook Live yesterday from John Limbacher, who talks so much about language and messaging, that's the most important thing to know, how to talk to your client, what your message is, and again, go to makemoneywhileisleep.com and you can read more on that. I'm gonna skip over this a little bit fast because I'm gonna get into the nitty gritty stuff. You can go tomorrow and watch that, from yesterday and watch that. Okay, your website. How many have a website? Okay, awesome. So, make sure your website speaks to your avatar, speaks the language of your avatar. So I'm going to give the example that John gives all the time, and I love this example of one industry that makes the hugest, biggest mistake usually with their websites, and it's usually realtors. We pick on realtors a lot because here's what a lot of them do. You go to their website, and it's this beautiful website. It all looks pretty with houses and stuff like that. And on one side of the page, it says, do you want to buy a house? I can help you find a house, the cheapest house, like the best house at the lowest price. And on the other side of the same page, I go, do you want to sell your home? I'm going to get the best deal, more than what your house is worth. So what do you think happens when people go to that site? If a buyer goes to the site and they go, oh, cool, we're going to get a, but wait a second, they just said they're going to, that makes no sense. That is not congruent, that's not, it doesn't feel good. So they're going to go someplace else. So make sure when they go to your website, it speaks to your avatar. So a realtor, for example, and think about this in your own business, go to the website. What they really should do is have a big giant button that says, do you want to buy a house? Click here. Do you want to sell a house? Click here. And then when you click that button, it goes in and only talks to the buyer, or it only talks to the seller. So maybe in credit card processing, maybe you have small business owners and you have corporate owners, right? So they probably speak a little bit different language because they need different services. So that's really important in your website. So segmenting. That's a word that you should know in all of these things. When you're marketing, you want to segment your audience. So you want to put, you know, if you're just talking to single moms or you're talking to Harley riders or whatever, make sure that it's segmented and they can speak the language of that avatar. So again, I just left that down there, makemoneywhileisleep.com, and just watch the webinar with Don. It's really awesome. And the last thing I'm going to talk about until we get on is traffic, because you need to do these things in the right order. You gotta figure out who your avatar is, spend a lot of time researching,
Then you need to learn to speak their language and create your message, what the message is for your avatar. And then you drive traffic. Then you go on social media. Then you go and do email blasts. Then you do your marketing and you start getting people there. If you drive traffic to a website that is all screwed up and it doesn't have the messaging right, you can spend all the money in the world, and like John says, it's going right down the toilet, because when they get there, there's like they're confused. And what's the saying? Confused mind doesn't buy, right? Yeah, they're like, I don't get it. Get me out of here. So, yeah. Oh, and also on your website, just little asides here that I'll think about is make sure there's a place to get their contact information. Make sure you have some sort of a lead magnet that's going to make them put their email address in or their contact information. One of the best lead magnets, best, is if you write a book, and you can seriously write an ebook overnight. I'm not kidding you. We'll talk about books next. You can have a book, an ebook, where they have a free download of the book, a free report, a free whatever, something that they want, which is a lead magnet. It leads them to, it's a magnet that leads them to be able to put their contact information in there and have a call to action. So that's that. Okay. So lastly, I'm kind of reiterating this from yesterday, so I hope you guys will go watch the video from John yesterday, because he's absolutely the best. But if your marketing is not working, if you're doing all this work, it's not working, you're most likely talking to the wrong audience. Your message, you might have the wrong audience or the right audience, but the wrong message. So there's work you have to do, unfortunately, with all this. And if you get it right, guess what? This is like a magnet. You're going to get all the customers that you want. Any questions on any of that? Okay. So now we're going to get into a little bit of finding opportunities to grow your business in maybe some unique ways. So I love this. Your big opportunity may be right where you are right now. You might be sitting beside somebody right now that could totally change your life, that could totally help you grow your business like crazy. You have no idea who you're sitting next to. So I'm going to give you my favorite opportunity story that happened to me. And maybe this will get you thinking about maybe something that happened with you or something that you can think about. So my story is this for opportunity. I love this word. That'll be the word of the morning here, opportunity. So one day, I was married to a musician for 13 years. And he used to get calls. He worked for a big agency in Los Angeles. He used to play for the biggest famous people's weddings or the after parties for the Golden Globes or big, giant, huge Beverly Hills events. And his band would get calls every week. He'd get a call from his agent and they'd go, okay, next weekend, here's where you're playing, here's your client, blah, blah, blah. Here's the songs they want, learn those, whatever. So one day, I was on my computer, and I was tutoring out of my house at that time, but during the day, I just basically was doing everything for him, and all of a sudden, I heard the phone ring, and he's on the phone talking, it was his agent, and he's yapping away over here, and he comes in the room, and he goes, oh my gosh, you aren't going to believe this, I'm playing for the Bachelorette, Ryan and Trista's wedding. It's going to be on international TV. Does anybody remember that? Ryan and Trista, the Bachelorette's first one. I think it was the first Bachelorette, Trista. They're the cutest little couple. And does anybody remember who saw that show, how Ryan won her heart? Anybody know that story? Okay, he used to write poems to her. That's throughout the show. He would write her a beautiful love poem, right? Well, I watched the show. That's like the only one I ever watched. And as soon as he said, I'm playing for the Ryan and Trista wedding that I knew was going to be played worldwide, I went, oh my God. I don't know what happened, but my brain just went, get on the computer, look at these poems. And I found one called Something About Her. I just thought the words were beautiful. It was one of the ones she really liked. And I printed it out and I went in the recording studio, because we had a studio in our house. I said, write music to this. Now, don't ask any questions, just write a beautiful, just hurry. Okay? He's like, okay. So a couple hours later, he brings me into the studio. Gorgeous song. I'm like in tears. It was so beautiful. I'm like, put it on a CD. We're going to the wedding planner and whoever we need to go to, your agent. So literally, we went to Beverly Hills. We went to the office.
played the song. They were blown away. The wedding planner went, got Ryan on the phone, himself on the phone, and his people. And long story short, he didn't get to sing it on stage, but Brad Paisley, the famous country artist Brad Paisley, sang the song. We got thousands and thousands and thousands of hits. Like, I got a website. I got the domain name. I got the website. We printed up things where they could get an MP3 of the song. And like within seconds of it playing, we had thousands and thousands of hits, and it was pretty awesome. So, opportunity. It's always hiding. It could be hiding in these crevices. There could be opportunity right in this room next to you, and you don't know it. So keep your ears and eyes open, because you never know what's going to happen. So think in your head if you can think of a time where that happened to you. So when, like I said, opportunities are everywhere. So I'm going to give you a little couple things with networking. Anybody go to networking groups, meetups, that kind of stuff? Yeah. So what usually happens there? Everybody's passing out their business card. And you go home with your big stack of business cards. You're so excited. And then before you get home, you get text messages and emails. And, I would love to meet you for what? Coffee. I want to go to Starbucks, and I want to tell you all about my business and what I'm selling, and I want to sell you all my stuff. How many times did that happen to you? Like, all the time? Oh my gosh, I have to tell you this story. So Susan and I did this little, it was like a little mini mastermind thing, and we had this guy show up, and I'm not joking. We went through this whole thing. It was all about him. Like, he didn't even listen to anyone else. We were masterminding. It was just him and his business, all about him. And we all went to lunch afterwards, and I'm not even kidding you. My phone had a notification. He's sitting next to me, and you're sitting next to me, literally, got a text message. He must have done this sitting next to me. And he must have went to the bathroom and called or something. He left a voicemail. He left a private message on Facebook and something else.
A text message and an email.
While we're sitting there, like, you've got to come to my office. I want to tell you all about my business. I'm like, are you kidding me? And he's got a horrible reputation in the city. Horrible. People, like, unfriend him. It's just terrible. So please don't do that. So I'm going to put a twist on it. I like to play games. So I just got a card from here. We've got Jane's card that's credit card processing, right? So let's say I got his card. I would do this. I have a tutoring center, let's say. So when I used to have a tutoring center, I'll give you a different example. I would take the cards and say, oh, here's a plumber. Let me see, how could a plumber who owns a plumbing place and a tutoring business, how could we help each other? So I'm thinking, I would go like this, and this happened. Okay, well, plumbers go to families' houses, the toilets get plugged up, right? The people that have kids, and I need kids for tutoring, so why don't I ask the plumber to, I'll say, hey, give away free tutoring sessions to all your clients. Just tell them, this is a gift, you can have a free tutoring session. And in exchange, I did the same thing for him. I promoted his plumbing company that said, here is an awesome plumber in town. So we helped each other. So was that better? So I ended up getting a ton of clients from him because he gave these free tutoring sessions away, and then they would enroll in my tutoring center, and I got him tons of business. So isn't that a better way to think about networking groups is how can we work together? How can we help each other? So that is my tip for that. And I've got one right here. Put your picture on your business card. Please, please, please put your picture on your business card. How many of you go and get the business cards and go, God, Gene, I cannot remember what he looks like. I have no idea what he looks like. I don't remember him. Sorry, I wanted that. I remember him. But seriously, do you ever get big stacks of cards and you look at them and go, God, I don't remember who that is. Anybody? Am I the only one that has this pet peeve? Anyway, seriously, put your picture on there because people will look at it and go, I remember her. She's one of purple hair or whatever. So, yes, it's just, and put a call to action. Use the back of the card, put a call to action, put your website. I have one that's suebrook.com/free gifts, and people can look at that and have a call to action where they can go and get my three top 11 marketing tips or whatever. So use that business card. I have better ways to use business cards. I'm going to talk about books and how this is the best business card you could possibly have in your whole entire life. It's this nice little book
we actually started helping people publish these, and these are awesome. They're not very expensive to produce, and who's going to throw this away? Nobody. Or they're going to give it to someone who might, it might help. So that's my spiel on business cards. Okay, I'm going to give you some other little tips because people don't think of these things. Email addresses. First of all, please get a professional email address. Okay, sue@suebrook.com. sue@igniteyourbizweekend.com. susan@susanshepherd.com. That does a couple things. First of all, it makes you look professional, more professional, right? But second of all, if people don't know your website address, it's right there. They can go to suebrook.com. It's there. It's easy. Make things easy. Make it easy for people to find you. And an email address, believe it or not, it makes such a difference. If you have a Yahoo or Hotmail or, God forbid, an AOL address, there are still people that have that. In fact, I'm moving to Northern California, and a whole bunch of people have that. And some people think they have to pay for it. I think some people are actually paying for that. Oh, it's so sad. Anyway, and this is a bonus tip I just added that I keep seeing I forget to tell people. Someone taught me this years ago. When you have a website, capitalize the first letter of each word. Don't keep it all in small letters. Does anybody know why you should do that? So some people have long websites, and you're like, you can't tell. One word might go into the other word. It's just too hard to tell what the words are. So it doesn't matter if people type in a capital letter or not when we type it in, but make sure, this is just a total bonus tip that nobody ever teaches, but all when you're marketing with your websites, make sure you capitalize the first word. So Susan's is gettingwhatyouwant.com. Well, if those are all in small letters, it might be hard to, you know, might mix them up and you can't really read it. So she needs to capitalize getting and then the W, you want that. Just a bonus tip. Okay, these are some, being nice. This is just a being nice tip. So always ask people before you add them to your email list. Always ask them, because when you're getting all those cards, how many people go home and they're automatically, they enroll them on some list that you're really not interested in, and then you have to unsubscribe. I have this girl, this is terrible, and she still hasn't changed it. And I don't want to do this, and I hate telling people this, but she put me on a list, and she just sends the emails from her Gmail contacts. There's no way to unsubscribe. So I have to email her and say, can you take me off your list? And then I feel terrible for having to do that. And then she probably goes, it doesn't feel good. So make sure you have a way for people to unsubscribe from your list. So that's just a be nice. the unsubscribe option. So let's see. All right, now we're getting into fun stuff, my favorite stuff. So how many people, avatars, do you think are doing this? They're on the computer. It looks like me, except I have two cats by me. So how are you going to get to those people? With Facebook, YouTube, all the reality shows, people want to know who you are. They really do want to know who you are. I am a graduate of the Goldman Sachs 10,000 Small Businesses program. Have anybody heard of that before? Not a lot of people have. It is Goldman Sachs, Babson College, number one entrepreneurial college in the world, came together a few years ago and took, they're still looking, by the way, for any business owners that have been in business. There's certain criteria, been in business 2 years, make a certain number of income, and you apply to be in this free program that basically gives you a business, you know, a business education. It's huge. So when I did this in 2011, you know what they told me? And a lot of business colleges still teach this. If you're an owner, you know, you need to be back here. You don't want anybody to know you. You need to get your systems all set up and let it run without you, and so nobody can see you, you know? But, well, it's not like that anymore. It's changed. With all of this stuff going on, people really want to know who the owner of the company is. They want to see your face. They just do. And they don't want to just see your face. They want to know that you're real and that you're authentic and you're just like them. So one of the best ways to do this is to get on camera and do video. So we got people, obviously, you got a TV show, you are out there in the world. Susan does live videos. I've been doing them all the time. There are so many people that say, oh, I don't want to get on video. My makeup's not right. My hair's not right. It doesn't matter. People want to see you the way you are. And when I get into Facebook Live, I'll tell you my story. I actually did one where I just got out of the shower, had my robe on, and had wet hair, and I was shaking my toothbrush and the thing, talking about what your morning routine is. And I got more engagement on that one than anything. And I didn't have makeup on, I looked crap, terrible, but people was, wow, she's real. She takes a shower and, you know, gets ready in the morning and brushes her teeth just like everybody else. So anyway, okay, I think I'm jumping around a little bit, but that's okay. All right, when we get into, when you're posting on social media, and correct me if you need to add anything, Karma, make sure, this is my experience. So I've had a lot of experience since January trying different things. And what I found is, if my posts or my videos are inspirational, like I'm reading some interesting books, I read really great books. So let's say I read Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. So I talk about the power of the mastermind, which we'll do some of that later. Talk about something inspirational. Give them an inspirational tip of the day. You know, something that gets people motivated and happy and smiling and learning something inspirational. I get so much engagement, so many people commenting and saying, oh my gosh, I really needed to hear that today, than almost anything. So when you're posting, inspirational has worked really well for me, or educational. So I might have something that I just teach. Like the other day, on Facebook, I posted, I believe that mystery marketing sells. I'm writing a book called Mystery Marketing. And my post that is kind of mysterious, I did one the other day that says, big changes ahead, you know, for me or whatever. I can't remember what the exact one is. I got 1.2 thousand views on this video. And I know it's because they went, well, I need to know what that is. So, but I got so many views on that as opposed to something that was kind of boring, you know. Like, so there's a lot of things, but the educational stuff really works, the inspirational stuff really works. And another two little bonus tips. These are just things that have happened to me. I don't know if you guys agree or anything, or have a story, tell me. But try not to add people to your group. If you do a Facebook group, don't just add everybody to your group. Some people don't care. How many have had somebody add their, maybe to their network marketing, it's a group and they're selling something in their network marketing, and they add you all in there. Maybe it's for men's hair products, but they add me anyway. I'm never gonna use that. So be really careful with that. Don't, just be nice. It's always about just being nice, right? And don't tag, oh my God, this happened to me, I think 3 times yesterday. Somebody tagged me in these posts, that something about a dog, and it's a picture of a dog, and then some other political post, and they tag me in it. Like, don't put me in that. Don't tag everybody in your post. Oh my God, do you agree with me? Do you see
I that? Definitely do. I turn off tagging. Just turn it off. And then no one can tag
me. Oh my God. I untag myself, remove tag, or unfriend.
It's easy for me. I don't even know how to tag.
But other people tag you, then it's like you're in there. And then if people comment, then you just keep getting more. Oh, holy cow. Don't do that. I have to give you all my pet peeves. Okay. All right. Here's my favorite part. All right. Who's done live streaming? Who's done Facebook Lives? Okay, we're going to change this. You guys are all doing Facebook Lives. Actually, in your radio show, Irma, you should be Facebook Living all your shows. A lot of people are doing that now. Lots of people are doing that. But you're shaking your head. So is this thing still on? Are you watching this? Okay. My battery died to this. Nick. So let me tell you my experience with Facebook Live. Well, like I said, inspiration with wisdom. Here's what I'm doing. Okay, I started January 1st, and I said, I'm gonna do a video every day. This is my New Year's resolution. And so what did I do? This is when Facebook Live was pretty new. It was really starting, people were just starting to really get into it. And so I thought, okay, I'm going to do a video. That was my thing, video, not Facebook Live. So I got my camera out and I set it up like this. And and I got all ready and got my hair pretty and my lipstick, and I do a video, it's like, darn it, okay, and I shut it off, and then I, you know, delete it, do another, and it's like, ah. And then finally I'd get one that was like, okay. So then I put it on my YouTube channel, and then I went to Facebook, and I posted the link to my YouTube channel, and nobody saw it. I spent all the time doing that video, and there's nobody. Nobody commented, nobody. What the heck? And then I heard from someone that found out that Facebook doesn't want you leaving Facebook. They don't want you to put your website link on there. They don't want links to anything except what's on Facebook. I'm like, okay, well, let me try this. So I took my pretty little video, and I just uploaded it straight to Facebook. And I got a few people seeing it, but not like what I really wanted. Maybe, I don't know, 10? I don't know, not very many people saw the video. So I did that a few times, and I went, okay, fine, I'm going to do a Facebook Live. Scared the crap out of me. Of course, I got my hair perfect and my eyes, okay, got all pretty, and did my Facebook Live, and it was terrible. I would delete it, and I would do one. And oh my gosh, life changed, light bulb went off. Hundreds and hundreds of people. Back then, like, everybody got a notification that Sue was live. That's amazing. And I get 800 views. I'm like, oh my God, these people are watching me. Then I started figuring it out, and I started doing it every day. And then, like I said, one morning I went, I'm going to try something. Because this one girl, I'll just back up a minute, this girl in my mastermind, she does Facebook Lives all the time in video, and she has over 1 million, now she's almost, I think she's at 2 million now, likes on her business page from doing videos. And she told us that the videos that got the most engagement, the more people watching, was when she'd get up in the morning with a robe and her hair was all over and she was just real. And I'm like, okay, fine, I'm gonna try this. And like I said, I'm, you know, hair's wet, no makeup, no toothbrush. I'm like, what is your morning routine? I'm like shaking the thing. I listen to positive books every day. I'm an Audible freak. I just downloaded like 8 more books. I'm listening to one about habits. Oh my God, it's fascinating. I have to give you that book name. It's so good. So I did the whole Facebook Live on your morning routine and why you should listen to something positive in the morning and not negative television and blah, blah, blah. And I got so many people commenting and asking questions, and it was just so cool. So that's what I figured out with Facebook Live, is people love it when you're real. They love education. They love mystery, and they love inspiration and education. So, who's going to do a Facebook Live every day? Anybody going to take a challenge? 30 days. Anybody do a challenge? 30 days in a row. Okay, let's do it. Yes, you too should do it. Really, try it. Even if it's just 5 seconds, just jump in. So, I had a lady the other day, I met her and I gave her a 60-day challenge, and she did it. She was a New York Life Insurance agent. And the last day, she went, I did it, I did 60 days, but I'm not doing any more. Don't look for me anymore. That was hilarious. She did it, though. Okay. Okay, and here's just some bonus tips if you want. Educate and inspire. Be yourself. Be authentic, like I already said. Be aware of what's behind you in your videos. Oh my gosh. Yeah. If behind you is like a whole bunch of a pile of dirty clothes, or, you know, something, a picture on the wall you don't want people to see. Or, you know what, if you're doing a Facebook Live, now I have my camera the different way, but when you do a Facebook Live and you're looking at yourself, everything is, if you have words, they're backwards. So people will hold up books, it's like, it's backwards. It's not going to be backwards, like they're seeing it the right way because I have my phone turned the other way. But be aware of what's behind you. I've seen people do it where there's animals running around, people, oh my God, so distracting, you can't even hear what they're saying. And have good lighting and sound. Don't be in the dark. Make sure it sounds good. That's good. And have a call to action if you're educating and you want people to go check out your website or your event, have a call to action to do that. And lastly,
always do three. Always do three calls to action. One in the very beginning, when you first open, you give them something and tell them what you expect from them. Also put it in your timeline. And in your comment section. Mm-hmm. And then once in the middle, and then one at the end.
That's good.
Yes, because people come and go on Facebook. So
that's true, and they see that. And then that's I just said the comment thing. So like I said, Facebook doesn't want you putting links outside. I will say the link, and then I'll say, find it in the comments below. Even if I'm just posting and I'm not doing a video, instead of posting the link in the actual post, say, look in the comments below for a link to my event. Then more Facebook doesn't notice that. So that's a really good tip, because I'm glad you brought that up. So, any questions on that? So it's all about being unique. It's all about being different. What makes you stand out? What makes your business really unique? So if you have a business that there's a lot of competition, just if you're doing Facebook Lives and people are seeing you and they're connecting with it and you're feeling your heart, it's just gonna be great. So now I'm gonna get into my best business card thing. I'm telling you, this is honestly one of the about three of my favorite best marketing tools is a book. And who has a book in here? Who's written it?
An actual book, or are you talking
an actual or an ebook?
Like an ePub?
An ebook too? Yeah. Oh, okay. Cool. So if you haven't, let me just make it really easy for you. Tonight, go online and find all your most favorite inspirational quotes, all your favorite quotes. Just go online and just find all your favorite quotes. And then title your book, Jean's Favorite Inspirational Quotes for Business Owners. I don't know, whatever. And just copy them and put them in the book. Just put one quote on each page of the book and then put your name on it and put it on Amazon or whatever as an ebook. And you could, and then we'll all buy it tomorrow for 99 cents and then you'll be a best-selling author. I'm not kidding you, it's that easy. I've had people do that. We know someone that did that. He went home and went, oh, okay, and he went and put quotes in a book. He made a cover and a title, and literally the next day he came to the event and said, okay, everybody buy my book for 99 cents, my ebook on Amazon, and literally, it's like, screenshotted it, number one bestseller. It's that easy, guys. So, but of course, if you wanna have a book to give people, these are awesome. I love these little books. This is Susan's, Dating After 40, No More Excuses. Anybody want one? Anybody need one of those? No, not married. No. So this is her book, and you've gotten clients from this, right? You hand them out all the time, right? Any stories about that?
No, what it is it's that little book is dispelling 10 myths people tell me they can't date after 40, why they can't find a relationship after they're 40 years old. And I just destroyed 10 myths in there. And what happens is they get a sense of who I am and how I think and how I operate. And they can recognize if they want to be part of my tribe, if they want to talk to me. And so then there's opportunity for them to make an appointment to talk to me, and then I get clients from it. They really get a sense of who I am from it.
But there are people that really want that book, but they go, oh God, I have a friend that really needs that, and they give it to them, right? That happens all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
And it's not just for people over 40 either.
But you know what? You could take that same content and put dating in your 30s, no more excuses. I mean,
exactly.
She could, the inside of the book could totally be the same, and then she just puts a cover on it. And then you have a whole series.
That's what Michael Gerber did, by the way.
Really? Wow.
That's why he has 30 bestseller books, because he just changed the title and wrote the same book.
Amazing. It's
well,
crazy.
It's like the E-Myth for plumbers, the E-Myth for electricians, the E-Myth for realtors, the E-Myth for this, and it's the same content.
It's
exact same content.
You just
change the words inside that relate to who it is.
We're going to write a book called Getting Married After 41.
There you go.
I love
Perfect.
That. Do that. That's good. You guys, these guys are amazing, by the way. One of the most amazing couples. If you don't know them, make sure you take some time to get to know them. They're super inspirational, and they're just such good supporters of me. So anyway, get to know those guys. But just about the books one more time. What happened to me was I was in a mastermind program. All he talked about was, you've got to write a book. Sue, write your book. And I remember it was, I think it was Christmas Eve, and I was home by myself, and I was like, okay, book, what am I going to write about? And I go, just write about what you know. Just write what you know about. Like, well, I know everything about the tutoring business. I had one for 19 years. I know everything about it. So I sat down and went, tips for finding the right tutoring program for your child. And I just wrote it. I mean, it's easy if I could do it with my eyes closed. And I took a couple weeks to edit it and have people read it and whatever. And I literally, I had no clue what I was doing. I went on Kindle, I think it's KDP. Anyway, I can't remember it off the spot.
KDP.
Yeah, it tells you exactly how to do it. You know, just read. You could do it yourself. You can hire someone to do it too. You know, Fiverr, you can get people to do it. Just come up with it, and you can go on Canva. If you don't know Canva, you can design covers on there. If you want to do all this for free, you totally can. And I just made a cover, and I figured out how to do it. I put it on Amazon. I went on Facebook and went, oh, look, I have a book on Amazon, and I didn't think about it. And literally the next morning, I had an email with a screenshot that I was the number one in like a couple categories. And how'd that happen? I'm an Amazon bestselling author. Like, I didn't even know what I was doing. It was totally by accident. So it was so cool. But you know what happened? Everywhere I went to all my networking groups, oh my God, you're the author. You're an author. And, oh my God, can I get your autograph? I'm like, what? What just happened to me? And then I got this printed when we figured out to do these little fun little books just this past year, and these are really fun. So I just got it printed. So what my goal for this is another thing you could do. My idea for this is, I'm not doing the tutoring business anymore, I sold it, but I could totally sell these books to all tutoring businesses all over the world, really, and they could put their own content on there, and I wrote the book. So anyway, there's a lot of ideas and things you could do. One other idea is this. So I did that as an ebook, and then they're like, well, you gotta have a real book. So, you know, you're in this mastermind and you get to get on stage if you have a real book.
Fine.
I don't wanna write a big book. That's too hard. Anybody think that? That's too hard. I can't write that many pages. So I said,
I don't have that much to say.
Yeah. I was like, I do wanna write a book, but I don't have time. So I called my mentor and I said, Can I just get other people to help, you know, write different chapters? He's like, sure. So I went and I put it out there. I said, who wants to write a chapter in my book called Discover Your Identity? My story, I'll tell you in a little bit, has a lot to do with me losing my identity and finding it again and how it changed my life. So I wanted to tell my story about finding my identity. And so then right away, I had 15 people say, I want to be in the book. And they paid a certain amount of money, whatever it was, and we made the book. And it was like, oh, well, that was easy. I just wrote one chapter. Cool. Everybody else helped me write the book. So this came out, and oh my gosh, did my world change. Because I took the books everywhere I went, and people wanted to buy them. They wanted to talk to me. I was famous. And when I did the second one, I'm at the post office, and I have my two books there. I'm sending them to my dad in Nebraska. And the postmaster was standing there, like, those are your books? And I had my pictures on it, and I was like, yeah. That's so cool. So if you just want to get a really good boost of confidence, just do that. So I do want to tell you what I did with this book. And I'm looking for authors for the third one, because three is a good number instead of two, isn't it? That's a good, is that feng shui kind of thing? Maybe not two. So I want to do the third book. The first one was Identity. It was stories of people discovering their identity. And then the second one, it was all inspirational stories, and Nancy's in it, and Susan's in both of these books. And the next one will be Discover Your Influence. It's gonna be a teal green book, and it's about how you can write about how someone's influenced you in your life, or how maybe you've influenced someone else or the world or whatever. And so what I did with this is I went, there's so many people. I was at an event, and I said, I had the idea just kind of as I was talking about it. I said, you know what? If you want to add a little extra, I'm going to give you the option to put your picture on the cover. So if you come over here at the break, you'll see that Kathy, this is one lady, she got her picture. It's the same exact book on the inside. She wrote one of the chapters. Susan's on this one, has her name on the cover. And of course, I have one mine with my name on the cover.
Show them the back.
What?
On the back of the book, too.
On the back and the front. So you can have an entire book like that and write one chapter. Anybody in for that?
No.
Okay. So I do have, if you want to know about that. It's usually $997 to do that, and then another $500 for the cover. But we're doing it this weekend for $497, and that includes, I think, 20 books. You get 20 books for that, so free books to go with it. So,
and it's getting what you want publishing.
Yes, Susan started the publishing company. She's so proud of her.
I just
you can all have your own publishing company.
Well, that's true too.
Yeah, you can. Anybody can have their own. Does anybody know this stuff? Like, nobody tells you this. You can have your own publishing company. You know,
and it's free.
You can actually do the whole entire book by yourself if you want. Now, the little books, you can. There's a thing called Create Space, by the way. You can write that down if you want. If you want to just go and do your book on your own with no help, you can go to Create Space. They do not do these little books, though. They don't do this size. So Susan and I can do these. So I will also, before the break, we'll pass out the forms. I'll show you what we're doing with these. These are normally, I have the slide up there. Let me see if I can. I'll show you that to you in a second. But if you're interested in these books, we have a great, great, great offer for you to help you. We do everything for you. We put you with somebody to do the cover and the whole nine yards and get them printed, and you get 25 books, I think, for free. And you can order more, and they're best marketing tool ever. So, I think I was saying here, what does a book do? It makes you an expert, right? Once you have a book, you're the expert. Nobody can deny that. Your name is on the cover of a book. Your picture's on there. You are the expert. So I don't know if anybody's done anything with credit card processing as being the expert, but, you know, be the first. I don't know. Does anybody else have a book? If not, be the first. Because people will go, well, am I going to buy from the plumber that is just a plumber in the Yellow Pages, or the plumber that wrote the book on the best plumbing? I'm going with that plumber. He's an author, for goodness sake. I'm serious, it will change your life. Super passionate about that. Can you tell? So how do you become an expert? You just call yourself. Yep.
Also, if you're struggling with writing a book, because I was struggling the last time we talked, if you're a blogger, you can take your whole segment, like I have from beginning to end of how to use Snapchat, you can take that, each one of those segments, and those will be the chapters of your book.
Absolutely.
And you can just go ahead and do it.
I love that. I did that with that second one. I didn't want to write my same story, so I have all these blogs on how life is like a road trip, and I have a bunch of blogs about different things, look in the rearview mirror, you know, look at whatever it is, and then I did this, yeah, I'm glad you, thanks for bringing that up. That's really good, yeah. Or if you've written articles.
Yeah, all your articles can go along with them.
Yeah. And if you don't have enough content, throw some quotes in there. I have quotes in that book. If you look at it, there's like one page that's just a quote. It's like, and there it is. What's the one that everything, there's a big giant book someone did that's everything, what was that?
Oh, everything men know about women.
Everything men know about women, and it's all blank pages.
Wow, that's cool.
You could do that. He seriously made tons of money, millions of dollars, a book with blank pages. Are you kidding
me?
If you have any other ideas, Laura, let's come up with some good ones today. So anyway, people want to know, like, I trust you. So the book gives you validity, and you're the expert. Being live on video, totally, people can see who you are and that you're a real person, and really important stuff. So I threw some other things in here. Oh, it's all about building relationships. So I like that picture. I thought that was the other day. So these are some things you can do to build relationships with people. It's not about trying to sell them. It's about building relationships and getting people to know, like, and trust you. So here's some ideas. Connect on social media and promote. Give referrals. I like this one. Our friend Casey Eberhardt, who is the ultimate network marketer or networking person who teaches networking and marketing and all that stuff, and he talks about this. You know, rather than making it all about you, give other people referrals, and they're gonna refer people to you then. You know, it's all helping each other. Introduce people to other people, offer value, interview, a nice to meet you card. One of my favorite best marketing tools ever that is super low investment, but the biggest impact you could possibly have in your marketing is sending cards and maybe even gifts to your clients. And I'll tell you the truth. My business, I started out of my home. So it was in my living room. I was so married to the musician. Won't get into the entire story, but long story short, I had given up everything in my life for him. Like, I did everything to build his music publishing company, his business, getting him gigs, the whole nine yards, and made him a lot of money. And when he suddenly left, and then marriage ended very suddenly, I was left like, what am I supposed to do every day? Every day was marketing him. It had nothing to do with me back then. And a couple months later, I was hit by a truck, like literally hit by a truck in my little Volkswagen Beetle. And I was lying there in the hospital. I was in their hospital for about 3 weeks and pretty messed up. I really shouldn't be standing here today. I was pretty lucky. And I ended up coming out of there, deciding I was gonna be the rock star. I made him the rock star, it was gonna be me. And I started my business back up. And I thought, well, I'm gonna start tutoring again. And I started with my jaw wired shut and my arm, and I had a brain injury, and I'm like tutoring kids, right? But I just did it. And I had no money in the bank. I'm 44 years old, I'm 55 now. 44, I have no money in the bank. I'm trying to start this business. Didn't know what the heck I was doing. And I literally built my business with no money, very little money. I didn't spend any money on marketing. I learned social media. I learned how to do a website. And I learned how to build relationships. I learned that, well, they were my family. It was easy because I was lonely at home. I'm all by myself now. And so my business turned out to be my family. So I formed really great relationships with the parents and the kids that I tutored. And I literally built my business from my living room to a 5,000 square foot educational learning center that I sold a couple years ago. And I built it doing this. A parent would come in with their kids, meet with them, talk to them, do whatever we did. And they, before they left the parking lot, they had a card in the mail, a thank you card, thanking them for coming in and excited to work with their child, whatever, whatever. It was so nice meeting you, and something personal about them. And I literally built my business doing that. And it didn't cost very much money. So the thing is, nobody told me that there was actually a tool that did this for you, where you didn't even have to go to the store, buy a card, bring it back, write it out, go to the post office, buy a stamp, put it on there, go to the post office, mail it, try to find their email. I didn't know there was a tool. But there is one, a tool. It's called send out cards. I don't know who's using that. Anybody using that? Okay. Yeah, there's a few people that are. If you want to know more about the send out cards, basically you have an app on your phone. You can go in, you can take a real picture. I go on social media, I go on Facebook all the time and grab people's pictures. Like if it's their first, my friend had got married and they had their daughter's first birthday, and they had these beautiful pictures of loving family with their little girl's first birthday. I stole the pictures off of Facebook. I shouldn't say stole, but I grabbed them off there, put them on the front of a card like this, and my information is on the back. My picture, whatever, if it's for business, I have my business information on the back. You can have your own handwriting. I push a button and they send it with sometimes a box of brownies. You can come and see what those look like. And literally within a week they get the box of brownies with the card, with the picture they're never gonna throw away. And it is the best marketing tool I've ever found in my life. And I would never tell anybody that if I didn't use it myself and see the results. In fact, my friend Margie, who's supposed to come pretty soon, is a realtor. How many realtors are out there in the world? Thousands. So she literally sent two box of brownies with a card. It comes like this in this cool envelope with the brownies. And she sent it to one guy who she sold their house 30 years ago. And then someone else, I think, was 20 years ago or whatever, sent them that. And that was like a few weeks ago. And I think she sold the house last night, and she's gonna make $100,000 over the listing price. She's gonna make a lot of money. It's a multi-unit thing. She's making $20,000-$30,000 by sending one box of brownies in the cards. Like, so I wanted that testimonial, now I got it. So there you go. So lastly, this last one's contacts. So when you're relationship marketing, you have your contacts. Some of those contacts are gonna be refer you to people. Maybe they're not gonna be your client, maybe they're not their gravatar, but build a relationship with everybody, because they'll refer you to someone
who may become a customer, or that contact may become a prospect, will become a customer. So relationship building is the best, and social media is a really, really great way to do that, if you do it right. If you do it right, okay? Don't just go on there and sell stuff every day. Oh my gosh. I'm starting to notice Facebook. Tell me if this is true. If I put something in the subject line that sounds like I'm selling something, I don't think Facebook's showing that to them.
They're not. Not anymore.
So. No. But be really careful.
Yes.
So don't sell this stuff. In fact, if you want to do any, get up and talk anything about social media, I would love it today. If anybody want to hear from, anybody want to hear some stuff from Carmen?
You need to get a Facebook ad. You need a Facebook ad.
There you go. We did a whole thing on Facebook ads yesterday.
Oh,
so, yeah. I have part of it is on my Facebook Live. It got, my gallery died, so it's not on there. But yeah, we had the Facebook ads experts yesterday, but you do that stuff too. So hey, we can get up and.
Yeah.
See, that's why you need to go live, so I can just friend you and just do this on.
So there, this is the last slide that I have that I just wanted to you to think about. So you can do all this marketing, right? The bottom line is this. What is that customer's lifetime value to you? Okay, I talked about sending the cards and how I built my business. And all of those things, relationship building things that I did, forming JV partnerships with people at networking groups. If you need to know this about your business. You need to know your customer lifetime value. It's not about that one sale. It's not about that one sale. I literally, I'm not joking, I finally dubbed myself the relationship marketing expert, especially for my type of business, a service-based business. I had kids that I tutored them when they were pre-kindergarten, so 4 or 5 years old, I started them. I tutored them all the way through, some even in college, and some of those had kids, or they referred people. And if I sat down and figured out my lifetime value, first, it's not about that first $500 or $1,000 sale when they were four. Some of those, thousands of dollars to me. So how important is it to keep that relationship with them? Like, ultimate important. So that's a homework assignment for you if you haven't done that. What is the possible lifetime value of a customer? Credit card costing, oh my gosh, I can't even imagine what your lifetime value is if you get a perfect customer, right? They stay with you forever. So yeah, super important. I'm gonna tell a quick credit card processing story. There was a guy that he used to live above me after my car accident, and he was in all these network marketing groups, and his big thing was credit card processing. And then I started my business, he bugged me. And then he came to my center, he's like, give me your bill, and I can save you all this money, blah, 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 like everybody says. And I'm like, well, I have a really good, a great credit card processor. They were great to me. They had great customer service. I'd already tested it out. I was happy with them. And then he said, well, you must not want to make any money then. And he treated me so badly that he had no idea that my business had grown. And so he lost so much money because I had so thousands and thousands of dollars worth of credit card processing. And if he would have been nice to me, and he would have built a relationship with me and said, I really want to help you, Sue. Let me just try, if I can. But no, he belittled me. He was not nice to me. He did not build that relationship. And then later on, it's like, would you watch me build my business into this, from being in the house to this big center? And it's like, he was eating crow, I think. Listen, I hope so. I hope so. So anyway, so that's that. Any questions on any of that stuff or extra things you want to add? Do you want to add anything, Karma, with any of the social media stuff and all of it?
No, I think you covered it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You did a good job.
Okay, so that is that. So, good stuff? Anybody get anything? That because I have so many things I can like to talk about. So let's take a really quick break, like 5 minutes, and if you need to go use the restroom, get something to drink or whatever. Anybody need a break or no? I just need a couple minutes to switch over here. I might have, let me pass out these forms for this.
I was gonna do a whole thing on this, but. Is anybody interested at all in the book, being an author in the book? I'll just pass both of these out.
Okay.
So this is the Discover Your I book for Discover Your Influence.
That's the one. That's mine. And it's coming out in my company color, so I can't pass that up.
So if you want to. Now, if you know anyone else. Oh, I did not talk about affiliate marketing. You know what? I think I'm going to real quick talk about affiliate marketing a minute. You're gonna go. I'll take a break. Oh, go ahead. There is a. I will give what is our $100 affiliate if someone gets another author.
Yeah. So
you get another author.
So what is the
author? So you get four, basically five stories, three. So I would love to get this book done, like,
you're not actually my first. Just thinking now, it's like, I can't possibly watch it right now.
Exactly. And I really want, as soon as I get, I'd like to get 20 authors for the book. Because 20 is like, if you want to look at some of these, like, you guys want to look at any of these?
I like this one.
Okay.
Look at some of them. Have some of them.
So
play around.
So they have a value.
Yes.
So there's some
Yeah.
Look at any of these and just pass them. Those are the ones that.
Put it out there.
Oh, I do want to say this. YouTube has a transcription service when you upload to YouTube.
I want to know about this.
Yeah. And so if you
do that,
yeah.
It's
so simple.
Really?
Yes.
I want to learn more about digital transcription.
Do they charge?
No, it's free.
Out of the world.
Wow.
Yeah. Crazy.
Yep, and that's what I was going to say. Facebook has it.
Okay.
You should tell somebody about this.
You load it, it takes, you manage to subscribe it.
Who does it?
In the Facebook?
Facebook?
Not Facebook Live, but your Facebook.
Yeah, they were all
under Facebook.
They were all, you know, all over the
podcast. See, I've been trying to Facebook ads for a while because I'm just not doing that yet because I'm moving and doing all kinds of stuff. But that's really awesome. And at YouTube, I created igniteyourbusinessTV.com, and I want to, in my Facebook Live, my goal when I get moved is I'm going to start interviewing people, like, have a big interview and then just put it on YouTube for my and be able to promote each other.
Well, what else also you need to do is you need to go, since you joined the challenge, this is what you do. You have one segment on YouTube that's for the Ignite Yourself Live challenge, or whatever you want to call it, and you have them upload that directly to that one specific one, and then that grows your channel because not all of the people who are in the challenge are all in that one. Yes, you can.
Okay, we got to
watch still on Facebook
yet.
Oh,
you're on Facebook. Hello, Facebook. So you could have to do something.
We will be right back.